Reading through the Old Testament, and I'm in 2 Samuel right now, and chapter 21, where it talks about David avenging the Gibeonites, how Israel swore to protect them, and then Saul tried to take them out, and then essentially to right this wrong, seven sons of Saul are sacrificed, killed, and I was just wondering, and then like the plagues go away. So I was just wondering how to like make sense of this chapter. It kind of seems like, I don't know, God is like allowing for human sacrifice, but clearly that would be like contrary to him.
Yeah, well, it wouldn't be human sacrifice because in a human sacrifice, what you're doing is you are presenting someone as an offering to the deity. And it sounds more like in this case, what was happening was the administration of justice. So this isn't so much human sacrifice as it is capital punishment. And it was capital punishment consistent with the mores of the day. One of the ways that ancient Israelites thought was in terms of a collective identity, to where people, and part of the reason for this was they didn't have police in the ancient world. What happened was you had, when there was conflict between two groups of folks, the conflict would spill over to include more than just the people that were at fault. So, for example, if I'm a member of tribe A and you're a member of tribe B, and someone from tribe A kills a member of tribe B, then tribe B is naturally going to respond. They're going to want to go after the person in tribe A who was the murderer. But because there are no police to adjudicate these disputes, what's going to happen is the members of tribe A are going to all rally around at least typically, they're going to all rally around the person who's a member of their tribe that the people from tribe B are trying to attack. And so what you get is this tribe on tribe warfare, where even though only one person committed the murder, more people than that are implicated in the resultant violence. And so as a result, there tends to be a collectivist attitude towards violence where in the ancient mindset, it made sense to them to say, well, we're going to have to go to war with tribe A now. And so we're not just going to kill the one guy, they're going to defend him. So we can take justice to get justice for our murdered member. We can wreak havoc on their whole tribe. And this made sense to them in the ancient world. They did not think in the individualistic terms that we do now. This is also like 3000 BC. I'm sorry, this is 3000 years ago. David's time is around 1000 BC. And so, over time, God tried to wean the Israelites off of this way of thinking. He created, for example, cities of refuge where a person who had committed involuntary manslaughter could go and take shelter and be protected in the city of refuge from the avengers of blood who would otherwise come after him. So God was trying to wean the Israelites off of this way of thinking, but it's still how they were thinking in the time of David. And so that to me would explain what's going on here, where since, David's looking to provide justice for the Gibeonites, and since Saul's family was at fault, he administers in his mind justice to Saul's family since Saul himself is not available anymore to administer justice to. That doesn't make sense to us, but it would make sense to someone in David's time. And if God chose to stop the plagues at this point that had resulted, you could look at that a couple of ways. One of them is the stoppage was coincidental, and some of the Israelites then may have interpreted it as being due to David's action. Or you could say, well, God knew he was dealing with a blunt instrument here. He knew he didn't yet have David and the other Israelites where they needed to be in terms of their moral education. And so they were trying to provide justice as they understood it. And so he rewarded their attempt to provide justice, even though it was through a flawed means. And thus he stopped the plagues for that reason, because at least they were trying to do justice, even though they didn't do it the right way, that the way that God would ultimately prefer.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this Catholic Answer, be sure to like, subscribe, and check out our live streams Monday through Friday, 3 to 5 p.m. Pacific. Or find the episode after on YouTube, your favorite podcast platform, or our Catholic Answers app.